Want to use Linux but cannot get rid of Windows? You can install both Linux and Windows together in one system. This is called dual booting, and I'm going to show you how to dual boot Linux Mint with Windows 10. Let's go. So this is one of the most requested videos on its Xbox. So let's first get Linux Mint ISO. So just head over to Linux Mint website, go to its download section. You'll see plenty of versions, so we will take the default desktop environment, which is Cinnamon. I'm using 64-bit, so I'll be downloading 64-bit ISO. There's option for torrent and there's option for direct download. There are so many mirrors. Actually, you can use any of them, preferably something which is closer to your country. Like for me, it's France right now. So you just download the ISO. It will take like 2 to 10-20 minutes, I don't know, it depends upon your internet speed. And the next thing is, we'll be using Universal USB installer, which you can just Google for it and go to its website. This is a tiny software that actually helps you create a live USB from the ISO you just downloaded. So just download the exe file and you have both the ISO now and the software to burn the ISO to the USB. Let's see. So plug in your USB at this time and then just run Universal USB installer. Agree to the software terms condition. Select the distribution. In our case, this is Linux Mint. And then browse over to the ISO, which is usually in your download section. And then select the USB drive. Select FAT32 format for formatting the USB drive. Don't need to put any persistent size. It's better to not do that. And then just go to yes. It will take like 4 to 5 minutes, sometimes even more, for Universal USB installer to burn the ISO image onto the USB. So this is actually the first part of like 4 or 5 part of installing Linux Mint with Windows 10 on the same system. So the second part of doing the dual boot, is to actually look for disk management system. Just search for partition and then you'll have the disk management system here. What we are going to do is to make some free space, a new partition where we will be installing Linux. So for me, there is C drive, which is like 220 GB, and I'm going to shrink this so that I'll have like 110 GB for Linux and the rest for Windows. So Windows suggests me to use 106 GB of free space, so I'm just gonna utilize that. Anything actually is good for you. It depends upon how much space do you have. For Linux, you can use anything from 20 GB to 100, 200, 500 GB, depends upon how much space you have got. So just for me, in my case, I'll be using 100 GB, which is sufficient for my uses. So it has created 100 GB of free space and 120 will be utilized by Windows. So we have a new partition where we will be installing our Linux system. Now you have to do is to restart your system, and do care to actually press F10 or F12 to go into the boot menu. So when you are seeing the Dell or Acer or whatever screen at the boot time, just press F12 or F10 or F2, it depends really on your system. in my case it's F12. So I'm going into the boot menu. Your USB should have been plugged in by now, so you'll see that option to boot from the USB. So just boot from that, and in here you will have the option to go into the live session. This live session is not actually doing anything, it's just that you can use Linux in a live session straight from USB, and when you unplug the USB, your system will be like untouched. But we'll be using the same session to actually install Linux Mint. So there will be an option to install Linux Mint on the screen. Just double click on it, and then you have to give some parameters. I don't prefer to install third-party software, I recommend the same. Just continue with it. The important part here is to go to something else. This is my preferred way of installation, and this is actually quite recommended, because if you install it with Windows Boot Manager, it will try to install in the same directory where you have Windows installed already. This is not what we're going to do. We'll be using the new partition which we created for this purpose. So just go to something else and continue. Now this is the most important part of the installation. Look for the free space you just had made in the previous step, which was like 110 111 GB for me. There it is. So now Windows has 126 GB, and there is free space of 111 GB for me for Linux Mint. So just click on the plus sign here to create some partition in it. What we are going to do is, like, we'll be using creating a root partition, and for that, since I have 100 GB, I'll allocate 20 GB. The recommended is like 6 GB, but I would recommend anything above 10 or 15 GB, and it depends upon how much size you have got. So 20 GB for me for root size. And the second is swap partition. It's quite debatable, like, how much should be the swap size. The safe is, like, if you have more than 4 GB, just keep half of the RAM size as swap. You are not obliged to actually use swap size if you are running out of space, if you have disk crunch disk space. And the rest of the free disk space you can allocate to home. This is where you will be you'll have all your files stored, like documents, download and stuff. Just click on install now, and it will give you a warning that you'll be creating some new partition. Continue. So now actually you have done the crucial part. Now it's just click and play. So I'm already connected to internet, so it will know my position, location and everything. So I'm going to use the English keyboard. Just create whatever username you want. I mean, it's really up to you. Do create a password, actually, it's kind of mandatory. Don't go for login automatically. I don't prefer encryption, because it might actually create an issue if you forget your password, and then you'll be losing all your disk, and that's not a good situation to be in. I mean, it's a security feature, but it might actually do some harm to you if you're not gonna use your Linux partition that frequently. So altogether, the process now will take 2 to 3 minutes, actually. That's right. I mean, 2 to 3 minutes, it's usually the Windows 10 update takes like 15-20 minutes, but if you're installing Linux, it takes like 2 minutes. So just to restart now, I have switched to camera view now, so that you can see actually the boot process here. So we have installed Linux Mint, we have just dual booted it. So let's see how exactly the boot menu, the grub boot menu, looks now. If you look close enough on the next start, you will see that there's a screen which says Linux Mint, and then Advanced option, and then Windows Boot Manager. The Windows Boot Manager is the option to go into Windows 10, and the first and the default option is Linux Mint 18. So if you don't choose anything, by default it will go to Linux Mint. If you have to go to Windows, you can choose Windows Boot Manager. And there you have like two operating system in one machine. Just go to enter your password and you'll be using Linux here. And that's it. Perhaps I'll do another tutorial on how to use Linux Mint, like just getting started one. And yeah, we are closing to the end of our tutorial. So if you find it useful, do give a thumbs up. It actually means and helps us a lot, and it actually motivates us to create more Linux videos. So in the after this, we have actually selected Windows Boot Manager, and now we are going to Windows. So you see Linux and Windows together. It's nice, isn't it? Do subscribe to our channel and give it a thumbs up. Stay tuned for more Linux tutorial. Signing off now. Bye bye.